If you've ever been to an FWP game check station, you've probably noticed that biologists don't seem to be interested in looking at the antlers on your animal, but just the teeth. And it's because of the story that the teeth tell. Let's take a look at where these teeth go.
For over 50 years, Mattson's laboratory in Manhattan, Montana, has been processing and aging animal teeth. Owner Carolyn Nissler walks us through this process.
All right, so this is the way that we receive teeth, and they usually come to us in envelopes. These happen to be wolves and brown bears from British Columbia. Once we get the teeth, we come put them out in our cleaning trays. So they soak overnight, and then in the morning they're cleaned, and we actually trim the root tip. That's where the growth layers are. We'll trim off the root tip and continue through our lab process.
Once cut, these root tip trimmings are embedded in paraffin wax and placed in this machine, which is used to slice the trimmings into thin sections. Carolyn explains why it is important to cut multiple sections of the same tooth.
This happens to be the world record archery elk that was harvested in Montana in 2016, I believe. And you're looking at the four root tips from the same tooth. And so if we can look at it four times and we get the same age four times, in this case, the age was six, we are pretty darn sure that was a six-year-old animal.
Once the sections have been cut, they are brought to the next step in the process where they will be mounted onto microscope slides. Once mounted to the slides, it's time to remove the paraffin wax so they can get a clear image of the tooth under the microscope. These chemicals will remove the wax, but allow the teeth to remain adhered to the slide. The final step is putting a cover slip on each slide. This protects the sections of teeth during shipping and ensures that they will last for many years to come. Once the slides are cover slipped, they are ready for aging. But how exactly can they tell an animal's age from a tiny section of tooth?
So right now, AJ is looking at a brown bear from Alaska, and this is actually a 39-year-old brown bear, which ties for one of our oldest bears. But if you can see on the image, what he's looking at are the growth rings in the bottom of the tooth. And so just like a tree has an annual cycle where it's got a quick growing season and then a short dormant season, it's laying down these alternating growth rings, and we can look at those through the microscope and tell how old a bear is, or a deer or elk, in the same way that you can age a tree.
Isn't it interesting the stories that teeth tell? Here at Fish, Wildlife, and Parks, we wish you a safe and successful hunting season this year, and go out and make your own stories.